السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this lesson, we are going to discuss cost control. From its name, cost control is the process of monitoring and controlling the actual cost of any construction project. So what we would like to do in cost control? We would like to monitor the cost performance, ensure that only authorized project changes are included in a revised cost baseline. And here you might find some project managers who are making something called gold plating. Gold plating meaning giving to the client, as a from a contractor point of view, more what than the contract says. So if you applying cost control, the project manager or whoever is responsible for the project cannot give more than what is already in the contract. Otherwise, we need to issue a project change order for the contractor to execute additional works or even to change some specification of the project. Also, informing project stakeholder of potential impacts to the project that will affect costs. The concept of cost control is to have a proactive action in terms of cost. As we agreed, project management all about being proactive. When you know how your project is performing, you can advise the project stakeholders like your company owner or the client or whoever that something is not going correct. Earned value management or EVM is not part of cost control process. And this is something confusing a lot of us, because we use earned value management terms such as planned value and earned value for monitoring the project progress only. This is not cost control, and we are not dealing with actual costs. Cost control use a term of actual cost and budget cost. I know it might be confusing. That's why I prepared for you this nice table where we can find the differences. So here we have the earned value management terms, and here we have the cost control terms. And now let's make one simple term like planned money, actual money. The planned money in the earned value management, we call it planned value. While the planned money in the cost control, we call it planned cost. So what are the differences between planned value and planned cost? Planned value, the value of the planned works by its selling price or the BOQ rates. So this is the expected amount you are going to claim in your invoice. While the planned cost, regardless of the planned work, doesn't matter what you plan, planned cost is the money should be spent on the work done or the executed work. You executed some certain scope of work and you should spend this money. This is what is called planned cost. When it comes to the actual money in the earned value management, we call this one earned value. The value of the executed work by its selling prices or the BOQ rates. While in the cost control, the actual money, we call it actual cost. The actual cost, that is the company actually paid or going to pay to the executed work done. If you notice in Primavera, if we are not performing cost control, you will find always that the earned value will equal to actual cost because we are not performing cost control. But if we are performing cost control, you will find big differences between the earned value and the actual cost. Okay, so cost control, when we say cost, we have two types of costs. We have direct costs and indirect costs. So what is direct cost? Direct cost is the amount of money spent directly to complete the work, like the material, the labor, the equipment, any direct costs related to the activity. While the indirect cost, the cost that we cannot segregate or assign to a specific activity. For example, the amount of money spent to support completion of the work, like the head office, engineering salary, etc. You cannot assign this cost to a specific activity in your project. That's why we call it indirect cost and will be distributed over all the project. So here we have some terms in the cost control. Like we said, that we are ahead of a schedule or behind the schedule or on a schedule, we can say here we are above budget. It means the project expected costs are more than the planned cost. It means the actual cost is more than the planned cost. It means something bad because we are above budget. Don't let the word above mislead you, because this is something bad, not good at all. The second scenario, we can be below budget. We always would like to be below budget. The project expenses costs are less than the planned cost. So the actual cost is less than the planned cost. And there is a rare case scenario where we are on budget, where the project expended cost are equal to the planned cost, where actual cost equal to the planned cost. So we know now the terms of the cost control. Why do we need to make cost control in our projects? The simple answer to this question is we need the cost control to forecast the project profit before it is completed. So before the cost control concept, the financial department can give accurate information about the project profit after the project is completed. But since this is not aligned with the concept of the project management, where we would like to be always proactive, then the cost control will give us the information at very early stage during the execution. So this is the benefit from cost control. Cost control can limit the use of materials to the actual limits and fully control the stores. For example, the site engineer might ask for 500 meter square of tiles for ground floor in certain building. But if this project is performing cost control and there is good communication between the cost control department and the store department, then the store can give only 450 meter square because the actual quantity of the ground floor is only 450 meter square. So in a proactive way, we prevented from a wastage of the material. Let me give you another scenario of the benefits of cost control. While we are doing cost control, we are monitoring the productivity of the groups. So here we have three groups. The three of them are doing the tiles installation. So we have group 1, group 2, group 3. Here we monitored the actual productivity, where we find that group 1 needs 5 hours per meter square, while group 2 took 5.0 hours per meter square. Group 3 took 4.8 hours per meter square. If we consider that the planned productivity is 5 hours per meter square, what does it mean? It means that the group 1 is within budget because the actual productivity is very similar to the planned productivity. They are doing good. While group 2 is above budget. Why? They are spending more hours per unit than the planned. So here they are spending 5.2 hours per meter square, while they should spend only 5 hours per meter square. You might think, Annie, this is very less differences. But imagine if you are doing thousands of tiles installations, you lose thousands of hours. The group 3 is performing better than the planned productivity, so it is below the budget. So now, if I'm a project manager or a construction manager and I would like to terminate one of these three groups, in your opinion, which group I should terminate and why? Definitely, I should terminate group 2 because they are spending more hours than expected. They are making the company paying more money than required. In the other hand, if I would like to give a reward to one of these groups, I would like to give them a bonus. Which group I will give? Definitely group 3, because they save already hours for my company. During my experience in construction projects, we was doing something like this, and we make a reward and punishment system based on the productivity. So every week or every couple of weeks, we publish the actual productivity rates and tell the department that, okay, you are doing good or you are doing bad. You need to enhance your productivity. You need to find what is wrong. So cost control, without cost control, we couldn't do this at all. What do we need from cost control in our project? Cost control can forecast the at completion actual cost. For example, if we finish 25% of an activity with an actual cost of 10,000, what could be the cost at completion? Very simple formula that you make cross multiplication and you can find that the cost at completion will be 10,000 multiplied by 100 divided by 25. Then we can simply calculate that at the end of the project, we are going to spend this amount of money. This is very simple, of course, formula, but this is also the basic or the concept of cost control, that I'm going to tell the project manager or the company owner, okay, if we continue by this performance, this project would cost like this. And accordingly, we will know if we are making a good profit or we are making some losses. So how we are performing cost control? In order to perform the cost control, you need to have your baseline. I remember baseline. Is it the schedule? No. We need to have a baseline for our cost. It means each activity in our project, we should know the actual cost should be paid for it. In that case, it shouldn't be actual cost. We need to know the planned cost. So here, we should first create our baseline. Then we will create some forms to collect the data. And this is very important. You might think, oh, this is not important. No, this is very important because you would like to collect the data in a way will be aligned with your baseline. When I say baseline here, I don't mean a schedule. I mean an Excel sheet that contains the project BOQ items linked to the activity of the project, and there is a cost or direct cost and indirect cost, so I can monitor easily. These forms should help me to fill here the fields where I can collect the progress and then report progress and take actions. It is very simple process if you understand how it works. So cost control baseline plan should include the following: activities required man hour per profession. So I need to know each activity, how many hours I should spend, and for the professions as well. I should know the equipment, how many hours I need for the equipment. And finally, I should know the materials. This is a sample of a cost control sheet where we have here the activity information. We have here the BOQ item. We have here the labor plant cost, equipment plant cost, material plant cost. Then finally, we have the total plant cost. We should have it per activity level and per BOQ item if you would like to perform a cost control. Okay, so now developing cost control forms should fit to the baseline we created. So we need to have some daily reports from site engineers. We need to have material store daily report to track the material usage. We need to have also equipment daily report. Collecting progress will give us the opportunity to evaluate the actual work and compare it to our baseline. After we collect the progress, we can then able to create nice report about productivity performance, material usage, equipment usage, engineers performance. Oh, how we can evaluate engineers performance? Think a little bit about it. If we can link the scope of work for every engineer, then we can evaluate the productivity, material, equipment for this engineer. And this would be a very good evaluation criteria as well. And then we can make project overall performance. Further action could be taken based on progress observations, and you may need to revise your baseline or develop a catch-up plan. Or even you might find some mistakes or something is going wrong in a certain area or floor or building in your project. This will give you a very good alarm in order to investigate further and check what is going wrong. So if you like cost control and you would like to know more, you are welcome to check our cost control course. Or if you would like to have us to do for you some cost control reports and forms, you are welcome to check our services and reserve a free consultation meeting with us. We are doing both training and services in project management. I hope you find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.